1, 2, 3, 4.
The word photography is derived from two Greek words, photos meaning light and graphene meaning to draw. Sir John Herschel, in 1839, was the first one to really give photography the name it currently holds. But we'll get to that later. Keep him in the back of your mind as we travel back in time a bit. Around 330 BC, a man named Aristotle was the first to question why, when shining through a square hole, the sun could create a circular image. Which of course prompted Alhazen to invent the first ever camera around 1000 AD. Today we might call it a pinhole camera, but really it would be called a camera obscura. Back then it was pretty much a dark room with a few mirrors, boxes, and holes involved. And it was incredibly good at making images appear upside down. So with this invention, a French inventor named Joseph Nicéphore Niépce created the first photographic image, which some people refer to as a heliograph or sunprint. Another Frenchman named Louis Daguerre partnered up with Joseph Niépce to create the new process of fixing images on a metal sheet. But this metal sheet was heavy and rather expensive. Now remember this guy? Herschel came up with a new idea. The idea of making glass negatives, which sort of replaced the metal technique, which was known as daguerreotype. In 1851, Frederick Scott Archer used this glass plate method to create a wet plate negative. And in 1879, dry plate negatives were invented. Film imprints continued to develop over time. And in 1888, George Eastman invented the first simple Kodak camera, which was factory-based. In other words, it was loaded, processed, printed, and reloaded in a factory. He also invented film that could be rolled in 1889, and purchased Raton filters in 1912. So now we move along to changes in cameras throughout the years. In 1905, we have Oscar Barnack's 35mm. In 1948, Edwin Herbert Land's Polaroid. In 1984, Canon the first digital camera. And in 1986, of course, Fuji's disposable camera. Because the camera developed into something so incredible, people stopped using it for scientific research and started to use it for art and documentation. In a sense, it changed the world. It's thanks to famous photos like these, which brought attention to the unseen and the unsaid. They changed history. They changed our lives. So thank you to people like Alfred Stieglitz and his wife, Georgia O'Keeffe, people like Ansel Adams, and so many others, even the modern photographers. Thank you all for making our world so full of life, so full of moments that can be captured on film, so full of photography.
Song to say what you done.